Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into the latest and greatest from the KDE project, the KDE Plasma 6.1 beta. There is a lot to cover, so let's break it down. KDE Plasma is a popular desktop environment for Linux, known for its customization and performance. The KDE team just released the beta version of KDE Plasma 6.1 and it's packed with exciting new features and improvements. This version is still in testing, so you may run into some bugs, but it gives us a great look at what's coming. First up, we have the explicit GPU synchronization feature. This may sound technical, but it's a big deal, especially for those of you with Nvidia graphics cards. This helps the system decide exactly when to show frames on your screen, reduces lag and fixes graphical glitches, making everything look smoother. If you had problems with Plasma while on session before, this update should solve many of those issues. Next, KDE Plasma 6.1 introduces triple buffering. This is a technique that makes animations and transition on your screen smoother. You'll notice less stuttering and a more polished experience overall. Flatpak is a system for distributing applications that work on almost any Linux distribution. Plasma 6.1 improves support for these apps. Your Flatpak apps should run better and integrate more smoothly with the rest of the system. There is a new remote desktop page in system settings. Easily set up and configure remote desktop logins using RDP, short for Remote Desktop Protocol. This is great if you need to access your desktop from another computer or help someone troubleshoot their system. Plasma 6.1 introduces a hide cursor effect that automatically hides the mouse pointer after a period of inactivity. This is especially useful for presentations or whenever you're watching a video. Notifications in KDE Plasma are getting better. They are now more informative and customizable, helping you stay on top of what's happening on your system. You can now manually save your session on Wayland. This means you can save your open applications and have them restored the next time you log in. Kicker, the application launcher, now lets you do calculations and unit conversion directly. Just type your math or conversion query and Kicker will show you the answer right there. WireGuard is a modern, fast VPN protocol and Plasma 6.1 improves support for it. Setting up using a WireGuard VPN is now easier and more reliable. Shake cursor to find it. This feature is now enabled by default. When you shake your mouse, the cursor will become larger and easier to see. Perfect for those moments when you just can't find your mouse pointer on a busy screen. If you have a laptop with an RGB backlight keyboard, this one's for you. Syncs your keyboard backlight's color with the system's accent color. This results in a more cohesive and visually appealing setup. Snap is another package format like Flatpak, and now you can manually update Snap apps from Plasma Discover. This gives you more control over your applications and assures you always have the latest features and fixes. Power and Battery widget has received several enhancements, more detailed information and better management options for your device's power and battery usage. Direct scan out for rotated screen. If you use a rotate screen setup, Plasma 6.1 supports direct scan out. This improves performance and visual quality for rotated screens. X Wayland is a compatibility layer for running X11 apps on Wayland. KDE Plasma 6.1 offers better support, means these apps will run smoothly and with fewer issues. Sessions restore for Wayland. There is a new experimental feature that tries to reopen the apps you had open when you last logged out. This saves time and gets you back to where you left off more quickly. The system settings page are getting a fresh modern look, easier navigation and a more pleasant experience configuring your system. The final release date of KDE Plasma 6.1 is scheduled for June 18, 2024, but if you're eager to try it out now, the beta is available. You can test the beta on OpenSUSE Tumbleweed or KDE Neon distributions. But remember, it's a beta version, so you may have some bugs and is not recommended for critical work. Overall, KDE Plasma 6.1 is shaping up to be a fantastic update with significant improvements and exciting new features. Whether you're looking for better performance, new functionalities, or just a more polished experience, there's something here for everyone. If you're a Linux user, this is definitely an update to look forward to. And as always, if you find this video useful, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you on the next one.